Why does my profile look like a fish? Hold on. Baby shark doo 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 doo. Damn. Hey y'all, and welcome to another Booty Goo video. So today, I'm gonna be sharing with y'all how I damn diddly messed up my damn skin, but also how I got her back. So 2 months ago, this is what my skin looked like. I actually gave myself chemical burns, which obviously left me with very intense scarring. So it was definitely a careful process to take care of my skin and to heal it to go to this state. I am not wearing a lick of makeup. So let's look at her real quick. So to make a long mother freaking story short, I fell into that trap, that consumerist trap that, you know, I need to use like 12 skincare products in one routine. You know that episode in SpongeBob where they go inside his brain and there's a bunch of mini SpongeBobs and everything's on fire, the papers are flying? That was my skin. She was freaking out. She was purging because she was like, what is all this crap that you're putting on me? Like, I don't like this. I had developed cysts and nodules from over applying way too many products, and I had over exfoliated my skin with chemical exfoliators. Exfoliation has a lot of amazing benefits for the skin. It helps with scarring, hyperpigmentation, it helps to increase cell turnover rate, but too much of a damn thing is too much of a damn thing. So this is it, y'all. This is the, oh damn, Satanás does not want me to tell y'all the truth. So this is it. This is the product that gave me chemical burns. It is the Ordinary Salicylic Acid. On the third day that I doused my skin in this product, I woke up with my face on fire. So I go to the bathroom immediately and I have like these huge red patches. I started forming boils, like these boils like you get from a burn, and they kept getting bigger and they filled with like fluid. So I thought, okay, yeah, this is a burn. And of course, this is an acid. It is possible to burn your skin. I had completely ruined my skin barrier, which made my skin very vulnerable and it had no defense system. So I had to work on repairing my skin barrier to make it healthy and strong again. And this is what I did. On the very first day where my burns were still fresh, I used colloidal silver ointment. This is just basic wound dressing gel. I basically applied it like every single hour because it just helped with the burning sensation and it was helping a lot with the swelling. My blisters eventually popped. Then they scabbed over and they were very deep, pervasive scabs. After the few days when they scabbed over, I went on to the second thing that I did, which was resuming skincare, but only the essential steps. So at nighttime, I would only do two things. I would cleanse my face and I would moisturize my face. This is the Kokokine Oil to Milk Cleanser. It is a non-foaming cleanser. When you apply it to your skin, it's an oil, but when you apply water, it emulsifies into a milk. It contains sunflower seed, grapeseed oil, gentle surfactants, oat kernel oil, and oat kernel extract. Kokokind is hands down one of my favorite brands because they create products that are vegan, cruelty-free, fragrance-free, sustainably packaged at a decent price. I have actually been using Kokokind products since last year, 2019. So I was so insanely excited when Kokokind asked to sponsor me. And I'm so honored to share with you guys products that I genuinely love. If you would like to check out any of the skincare products that I talk about in this video, I will leave them linked down below in the description box. The cleanser is insanely gentle, does not dry out the skin at all. If anything, it feels more moisturized after using it. So I definitely recommend it if you have dry skin or just sensitive skin in general. It is vegan, cruelty-free, and the packaging is sugarcane plastic that is 100% recyclable. And the last step of the night routine was to moisturize. This is the Texture Smoothing Cream. It is vegan, cruelty-free, as well as fragrance-free. It contains celery seed extract, flax extract, tsubaki seed oil, ginseng, and squalene. It's honestly just a great overall cream for all skin types. My daytime skincare was just as simple as my nighttime skincare. All I did was moisturize and put on sunscreen. So when I wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy, brush my teeth to get rid of my stanky breath, I get the remainder of water on my hands and I splash it on my face. And that is when I put on my cream immediately to seal in that water. I used the Biossance Squalene Plus Zinc Sheer Mineral Sunscreen. I have been using this sunscreen every single day without a fail for the past 3 months. If you have any sort of drop of melanin in your skin, you need to get the sunscreen because it leaves me with a zero white cast. So I continued with my simple skincare for about 2 weeks, you know, just cleansing, moisturizing at night, and then moisturizing and sunscreening during the day. Eventually the scabs fell off of the areas and I was left with wham bam spaghetti and spam, you already know the ham, hyperpigmentation. Which leads me to my third step. I stopped using chemical exfoliators temporarily and looked into acid-free alternatives to kind of resurface my skin and help it recover from the hyperpigmentation without further traumatizing it. And that is when I started using this mask. It's the Cocokind Resurfacing Sleep Mask. I actually still use it. This is actually a staple in my current routine because I love this mask so much. No burning, no tingling, super gentle, but very effective. It contains radish root ferment filtrate, squalane, jojoba seed oil, and bakuchiol. So I incorporated this into my nighttime routine between cleansing and moisturizing. So every Tuesday night and Friday night, I would cleanse my skin, and then I would apply a thin layer of this all over my skin. I let it dry, and then I applied my face cream. And that's it. You just throw your little old booty into bed, you know, like Shark Boy, dream, 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 dream. And then you just wake up the next morning, rinse off your face, and that's it. You're done. I didn't know freaking Scooby-Doo was in my apartment complex. So I used this twice a week for about 4 weeks. And here we have it, y'all. Like, here's the before of my skin, how it looked. And this is the after. Alrighty, y'all, so that is how I ruined my skin and then healed my skin. Thank you to Cocokind for partnering with me on this video. Genuinely one of my favorite brands. They have products that are vegan, cruelty-free, sustainably packaged at an affordable price. I linked all these amazing Cocokind products down below in the description box for you to check out. Comment, like, and subscribe, and let me know down below what other kinds of videos you would like to see on this channel. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.